Hi, I'm Alma, and I'd like to tell you how I turned from black to white. I know it sounds crazy, but hear me out. I was born in a wealthy, loving family. My parents were amazing. They were smart, kind-hearted, and always there for me. I learned so much from them, and they encouraged my natural curiosity every step of the way. I know I wanted to be just like them when I grew up. They owned a large business that sold medical supplies, and it worked really well. They had many employees, and they always treated them fairly. This taught me how I should behave around other people. No matter their social status and their race, I should always be kind and polite towards them. Now, I have to admit that we were one of the few black families in my neighborhood as I grew up. Most of the kids in my school were white, and I knew few people who looked like me, except for my family. I didn't face much racism during my early years, quite honestly. It seemed like as long as my parents were wealthy, people didn't much care about it. I made friends easily and was rather popular at my private school. My parents always pushed me to try my best, and I was one of the best students at school. I participated in lots of after-school activities and even got to be president of the student council, so I was a bit of an overachiever. Everything would change for me one fateful day, though it started so small that no one saw it coming. That morning, I woke up as usual and took a shower. I was soaping myself up when I noticed a lighter spot on my skin next to my navel. I completely freaked out. You see, my skin color was really dark. I wasn't a light-skinned African-American and looked just like my parents. I had long, curly, pitch-black hair and matching eyes, so the light spot on my belly really stood out. It wasn't brown or even caramel. It was pale as snow. I dried myself off quickly and threw on the first outfit I could find and rushed downstairs, completely freaking out. My parents were having breakfast downstairs, and they asked why I wasn't wearing my school uniform already. I showed them the light spot on my belly, asking them what was happening to me. They shrugged it off and told me it was something that could happen, and I shouldn't worry about it too much. It was a really tiny dot, like the size of my thumb. I breathed out in relief. I had been so scared for a moment, but the way my parents assured me it was nothing major made me relax immediately. I had never heard of anything like that happening, so I didn't know how to react. Apparently, it wasn't so unusual, so I thanked my parents and walked upstairs to get ready for my school day. When I got back home from classes later that day, I decided I would research my white spot online. I knew my parents assured me it was nothing to worry about, but I was naturally inquisitive. I wanted to know more about it. What I found on the internet basically supported everything my mom and dad had told me, so I decided it was best to simply shrug it off and let go of the issue. I'd have a small white spot on my belly, and that was it. It wasn't even visible unless I wore a bikini or someone saw me unrobed, so it was not that big a deal. A few days passed by and nothing changed, so the issue was quickly forgotten. That was until I woke up one morning a week later and noticed the spot had changed. It wasn't as big as my thumb any longer, but larger than my fist. I screamed and rushed downstairs. My parents were worried about my yelp, of course, and they asked what was wrong. I showed them my stomach, and that was when they really began to get concerned as well. A tiny little spot wasn't anything major, but this was getting bigger and bigger. They immediately booked an appointment with a dermatologist for that very afternoon. Usually it takes people longer to visit a specialist, but my parents' influence got me to the front of the waiting line right away. The doctor examined my spot, and he gave us great news. It was nothing we should worry about. He had seen these kinds of marks before. It could occur when certain chemicals got in touch with the skin, or it could happen naturally due to some minor issues with my genetics. So I shouldn't worry about it. It was again a great relief. Having a professional assure me that I shouldn't worry put me at ease for sure. I still wasn't happy about having this big spot on my belly, though. I was a teenager and kind of vain, so you can imagine my frustration. My parents told me I could cover with makeup if it really bothered me that much, but that I was beautiful no matter what, so I shouldn't think too much about it. I insisted, though, and so my mom taught me how to use makeup blends to cover the spot up. I planned on using this technique if I ever wore clothes that revealed my belly. Luckily, as long as I was wearing a dress or a t-shirt, no one would notice. I know maybe I shouldn't have worried so much about it, but the contrast looked so stark. I was so dark-skinned, and then that big, round spot was so pale. It looked like it was someone else's skin altogether. There was little to be done about it, so I tried to move on and forget about it. At first, it was easier said than done, but as the days turned into weeks and the spot remained the same size, I kind of accepted it as part of my body. I kept on going to school as usual and even went on a short trip with my debate club. We won first place during the competition. I was so proud of myself, and when I returned, my mom and dad took me out to dinner to celebrate. Everything seemed normal. Then the day before my 17th birthday, my world was turned upside down. Just as it had happened twice before, I woke up to notice my dark skin had white blemishes on it. Only this time, it wasn't a tiny spot or a fist-sized circle. Half my body was completely white. Everything from my stomach down was white as snow. You can imagine the way I looked, dark skin from my ribs up, and then white as a snowflake all the way down my body. It wasn't a spot any longer, it was the whole skin. I let out a blood-curdling scream, and my parents rushed into my room immediately, thinking I had some kind of accident. When they saw me, my mom almost fainted. It was impossible. How could this be happening? My parents immediately took me to see the dermatologist again. They didn't even book an appointment, they just dragged me there and demanded to be seen at once. The doctor was shocked by what he saw when I showed him my legs and stomach. He was baffled. It was clear he didn't know what was going on. My parents were furious with him. He had told them that everything would be fine, and now his daughter's skin had radically changed. They threatened with a lawsuit. You can only imagine how angry they were. That's when the doctor called other colleagues, and they began running all sorts of tests on me. Some were innocuous, some were a bit painful, but I endured them all. I wanted to know what had happened to me and how to fix it. A few days later, we received devastating news. My condition was irreversible. There was nothing we could do about it. My birthday had come and gone without any of us feeling like celebrating. My friends from school sent me messages to ask where I was and to wish me a happy birthday. I didn't reply to any of them. I didn't feel like talking to anyone. I was so depressed and concerned. My skin was so different from what it had been before. I looked like a completely different person, and there was no way of solving it. I'll be honest, I cried myself to sleep that night. And then the morning arrived. I looked at myself in the mirror, hoping the white mark hadn't spread. I was shocked to see what I looked like. I was white, completely white, from head to toes. Nothing remained of my black skin. I began crying, and it took me a while to go speak to my parents. I didn't know how to show them what had happened. It was as if their daughter was a completely new person. I didn't look anything like them any longer. I just looked like my classmates, just with really curly hair. Finally, I walked downstairs, and my parents looked at me in shock. My rare condition had taken over my entire skin. They hugged me tightly when they saw me so upset. They told me they'd always love me no matter what. After that, I didn't feel like I could ever go back to school. I ended up missing a few weeks, but eventually my parents insisted I return. I had to learn to deal with what had happened to me and face the world around me. I was, of course, seeing a therapist, but that's not a magical cure. It takes time to process such a radical change. When I got back to school, people didn't recognize me at first. You can only imagine how they reacted when they discovered who I was. Many of the students began mocking me, thinking I had done it on purpose, that I wanted to be white and had paid to get my skin to look that pale. I tried to explain my condition, but few people believed me. It took me the longest time to accept my new self. I spent entire weeks feeling really depressed, and even getting up in the morning was a struggle. I didn't recognize myself in the mirror, and I hated looking at myself. I didn't like the way any of my clothes looked on me. Little by little, though, I began accepting that what had happened to me was irreversible. There was no going back, and I needed to move on with my life. I got accepted into the college of my choice, and that did lift up my spirits somewhat. There, though, everyone thought I was white, so they were surprised when I showed them pictures of my parents. People would often ask if I was adopted. At one of my classes, I met this amazing guy, Mark. He was dark-skinned, just like my family. We began dating, and he made me feel happy and complete again. When he proposed to me, I revealed the truth about my condition and told him that if we ever had children, they might go through the same process. He told me he didn't care, and that if it happened, at least we'd know how to deal with it that time around. I was so relieved he wasn't freaked out. It proved that he was the right guy for me. My parents really adore my fiancé, and they are still as supporting and loving as they were all through my childhood. Honestly, I feel blessed, no matter what skin color I have. Mark and I are getting married soon, and we'll have a spring wedding. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and check out other videos in the channel.